language. Okay, so before you move to JavaScript, one thing, HTML and CSS, they are completely case insensitive. So either I can write in a small letter, capital letter, or a combination of both, it doesn't matter. But JavaScript is very much case sensitive and it follows the camel case coding convention. Okay, so as we already understood, you know, about JavaScript, it adds the interactivity of to the page, it makes the page dynamic, all those things. So where to write our JavaScript code? So we can write the JavaScript code either using internal scripting feature or external scripting. Internal scripting says just in the same HTML page, you are just going to write your JavaScript code. And external scripting says you are going to create altogether a new .js file and you are going to access that .js file in your HTML page. So let us see in action the same. So this is the example. So what is my requirement over here? It is a HTML page. Inside body, I have a element called p over here, right? Then I have a button over here. Input type is equal to button. Value is equal to click, which is nothing but the button name. OnClick equal to click me function. So what it is, OnClick is nothing but it's a JavaScript event. So when this click me function is going to be called, only if I click on that button, right? So it is going to call the click me function. Now, as I said, JavaScripting can be done either using internal scripting or external scripting. So this example, we are doing using external scripting. So the syntax what we saw is script element. Here you have to tell where is your .js file. So I'm telling script src source file, the .js file location is under scripts folder, we have a myscript.js. Just go and access that file. There you will get the click me function, right? So let us just open this myscript.js and see what is there over. This click me function, it is going to have, okay, so the requirement what I'm looking for, when I click on the button, that paragraph, I want to display some content over there. So first let us see the output. Then you will get a clear picture. So this is what we have, just a button. That paragraph is not visible, right? Because no content was written there. When I click, we are going to get the content. The paragraph is going to be filled up. So that's how we are going to make the page dynamic or interactive, user interactive. So how we have done it? So for that, first I need to fetch that element on which I want to apply that content or style it. So how we are doing it using document.getElementById. This is all part of DOM tree, which we'll be covering later on in the, you know, in the main training. So what it does, document.getElementById, here we are going to pass the ID of that paragraph, right? Let us just cross check. This P ID is ID 1. So how I'm going to access document.getElementById ID 1. And as I said, JavaScript is case sensitive. Make sure you are writing in a proper way. Otherwise you will get a error, compile time error. So now I got that element. I've just taken into a var in a var element variable. Using inner HTML property, we are just filling the content for the same. And using style property, using background color and color, we are just giving the styling for the same. So using JavaScript, we are inserting HTML element content as well as we are changing the styling. Actually, using JavaScript, we can do everything. See, here I'm just trying to access that element. Using JavaScript, you can create an element altogether. You can remove any element. You can, you know, update. Anything can be done using JavaScript on the fly. So that's how JavaScript is very interesting thing. It will make the page dynamic, interactive, all those things. Otherwise, if you just use plain HTML, CSS, your website will be just a static website.